Welcome everyone. My name is Bas van Heb and I'm a PhD student within BioTap, our research group within the Eindhoven University of Technology in the Netherlands. Our research focuses on the development of novel signal processing and control systems through neuro-inspired free energy minimizing agents. And in today's presentation, I'll talk to you about the variational log power spectral tracking of acoustic signals. If we have a look at the literature, then we can see that many probabilistic algorithms for processing acoustic signals will look as follows. First, you have our acoustic signal, which we will pre-process by applying some kind of Fourier transform and then by converting it to a log power spectrum. This spectrum is next up modeled using a probabilistic model for algorithms such as noise reduction or speech enhancement. In this presentation, I'll show you an alternative way on how we can model our acoustic signal by including these pre-processing steps in our probabilistic model. I'll start off this presentation by first describing how our probabilistic model will look like, and then I'll describe how we can perform probabilistic inference within our model. Our model will look as follows. So we've shown that we have a noisy observed signal y of n, originating from a true signal x of n. Throughout this presentation, we will visualize our probabilistic model using a so-called vector graph. In this graph, the edges represent our random variables and our nodes represent vectors within our probabilistic model. As we can see on the bottom right, we can see that y of n is modeled by x of n with an addition of Gaussian noise. Normally, what we would do is we calculate the fast Fourier transform of x of n. However, x of n is now a random variable inside of our model, and therefore we cannot do that. Instead, we will model x of n using a Fourier series expansion. Here, f of n represents the Fourier series basis, and s of n represents a vector containing real frequency coefficients. Normally, we would obtain, using the fast Fourier transform, a vector of complex frequency coefficients, but now, as our vector f of n contains cosine and sine terms, this means that our vector, the first half of our vector s of n, contains the real part of our normally complex frequency coefficients, and the second part of s of n contains the imaginary part. We can visualize this frequency common decomposition using a matrix multiplication in our vector graph. Next up, what we will do is we will convert these real-valued frequency coefficients to the complex-valued frequency coefficients by reparameterizing them. It's important to note that because s of n is Gaussian distributed, that our new random variable, our new random vector c of n, is distributed according to a complex normal distribution. And we can visualize this also in the vector graph, and now we can see that our time domain signal, or observed time domain signal y of n, can be extracted from our complex frequency coefficients through a probabilistic model. Next up is the conversion to the log power spectrum. And for this purpose, we will use a so-called Gaussian scale model. Here, our complex frequency coefficients c of n will be modeled through a complex normal distribution with zero mean and whose covariance is the exponentiated variable psi. Why can we actually do this? Well, because if we would take the maximum of this log likelihood, then we would see that it occurs when this random variable psi equals the logarithm of the squared magnitude of cn, which accidentally coincides with the deterministic transform from the complex frequency coefficients through the log power spectrum. So in our current model, we have now modeled our time domain signal y of n all the way through its time domain, its frequency coefficients, and its log power spectrum. To finish up our model to perform this variational log power spectral tracking, we will model this spectrum using a Gaussian random walk with step size k. Now that we have specified a probabilistic model, it's time to discuss how we can actually perform probabilistic inference within this model. Because of the many conditional independencies within the model, we can perform efficient inference through message passing. We can see this message passing as passing messages on the edges of a graph, each containing information about the previous part of the graph. If we were to do exact inference using the sum product algorithm or sum product message passing, then we can calculate an outward message of a certain vector node to a certain edge by taking the product of that vector node and the incoming messages, and then by marginalizing out all random variables except for the ones to which we are sending a random to which we are sending a message. If we cannot perform this exact probabilistic inference, for example because this integral becomes interactable, then we can resort to so-called variational message passing. Here we'll approximate our posterior distributions by tractable posterior distributions, usually constrained to a certain family of distributions. And through sending these new messages, these variational messages, we are effectively minimizing the variation of free energy of our model. In the current model, all required message passing update rules are readily available in literature, except for this Gaussian scale node, which transforms our complex frequency coefficients to a log power spectrum. For simplicity, we will drop all indices and subscripts, and we'll simply use the definition of this model as is now represented on the slide. If we were to calculate the messages corresponding to the sum product message passing algorithm within our model inside this Gaussian scale node, and we assume that our incoming messages are of the following form, then we can see that our outgoing message towards our log power spectral psi has this functional form, which cannot be directly related to a common distribution, and even the computation of our message towards C becomes intractable. Because mu of C is intractable, for this message at least, we need to resort to variational message passing, where we can assume that our incoming marginals Q of Xi and Q of C are given, as in the slides, similarly to the incoming messages of the sum product message passing algorithm. And using these incoming marginals, we can calculate the outgoing messages. Again, the message towards Xi has this uncommon shape, and we can see that this time, this message towards C, which was first interactable, is actually of the shape of a complex normal distribution. Now, the problem arises with this message passing is that these messages towards Psi do not belong to a common distribution. And because they are non-conjugate, the resulting marginals, which we obtain through multiplying the messages on the specific edge, these become intractable for future inference. So how can we deal with these non-conjugate messages, which have this functional form which does not directly coincide with a common distribution? Here we'll present three ways on how to deal with this particular problem. Our first approach could be to approximate this message by a Gaussian distribution using Laplace's method. So these messages with this functional form, we'll directly approximate them by expanding this function around this mode using a second order Taylor expansion. Because we expand it around the mode, the first order derivative actually vanishes, and therefore we are only left with this second order derivative. For some of the messages, we can actually find these modes and these second derivatives analytically. And if we are not able to figure them out analytically or manually, we can also always resort to automatic differentiation for this purpose. A second approach is that we could propagate this functional form. So this function, along our graph, along our edge. And instead of approximating this message directly, we will approximate the resulting marginal. So we'll first calculate the product analytically using this message with the functional form and the incoming message, and then we'll approximate the resulting marginal using, for example, Laplace's method. Which brings us also to the third solution. So instead of using this Laplace method, we can also approximate this resulting marginal using moment matching by performing Gauss-Hermite quadrature integration. Now that we have successfully specified our generative model and that we have described how we can perform probabilistic inference within this model, it's time to validate our approach. As a verification experiment, we have evaluated our inference performance for a synthetic piece of data by monitoring the variation of free energy. Here, the variation of free energy, the lowest one, results in the best performance. From this graph, we can see that the solution for performing probabilistic inference in this Gaussian scale node, where we approximate the resulting marginal using moment matching by Gauss-Hermite quadrature integration, performs best, followed by the approximating the resulting marginal using the Laplace's method. And the worst performing approach is where we directly model our message using Laplace's method. We can also see that there is a very minor difference in the performance when using some product messages or variational messages towards our variable psi. As a validation experiment, in order to judge whether the performance or whether it's actually possible to perform this variational log power spectral tracking, we will track the log power spectrum of an acoustic signal. On the left spectrogram, you can see the deterministic spectrogram as calculated using a short time Fourier transform and then by taking the logarithm of the squared magnitudes of the obtained frequency coefficients. And on the right, we can see that what these inferred values of our log power spectrum actually are. We can see that the most important features are actually retained. Of course, this comparison is not directly one-to-one, as psi represents this pseudo log power spectrum, which is not directly the same as this deterministic spectrogram. And we have also modeled this psi using a Gaussian random walk, which is differently than that of a deterministic spectrogram. So to conclude this presentation, we have presented a probabilistic model that directly models an acoustic signal through its pseudo log power coefficients. We have derived novel messages for performing probabilistic inference within this Gaussian scale model. And we have provided solutions for dealing with non-conjugate messages with a functional form. Finally, we have verified the proposed methodology on a synthetic piece of data by monitoring the variation of free energy, and we have validated our approach on a real acoustic signal. And with this, I would like to conclude the presentation. Thank you all for being present today, and do not hesitate to reach out for any questions. Thank you.